bad man. I'm a 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 man with a hole where a good man's conscience used to be. Walking around with a stone cold heart and a curiosity.
Whatever his agenda is fine. I mean, if it's making money or the whatever, or the concerns of the persons, that's his agenda. I'm not going to comment on that. But I think I will repeat again, from what I'm seeing on the ground, many Bahamians are not behind what he's doing.
I am looking forward to the government not asking me to prove who he was, but for them to tell us who he is. All we know is he signed the heads of agreement with this government, Mr. Speaker.
As I came in here, I heard those words, cradle of leadership. Well, when the bow breaks, the cradle will fall, and it has fallen here. It has fallen. Makers of men, creators of leaders, be careful what kind of leaders you're producing here.
The man who signed the heads of agreement, sitting next to the prime minister of our country, who later on, when it became controversial, went from being whatever he was then to being described as an ambassador.
Well, gentlemen, when the shit hits the fan, some guys run and some guys stay. Here's Charlie facing the fire, and there's George hiding in Big Daddy's pocket. And what are you doing? You're gonna reward George and destroy Charlie. He doesn't need to be labeled still worthy of being a bad man. What the hell is that? What is your motto here? Boys, inform on your classmates.
And so, Mr. Speaker, this individual who signed the heads of agreement of this deal with the government, who was had sufficient authority to do that, who had sufficient authority to do that, has the history that I've just described, Mr. Speaker.
Now, I'm just getting warmed up. I don't know who went to this place. William Howard Taft, William Jennings Bryan, William Tell, whoever. Their spirit is dead, if they ever had one. It's gone. You're building a rat ship here. A vessel for seagoing snitches. And if you think you're preparing these minnows for manhood, you better think again. Because I say you are killing the very spirit this institution proclaims it instills. What a sham.
There's some new revelation of this individual who heads the ambassador. Accusations, convictions, admissions of fraud and organized fraud, misappropriation of investor funds, U.S. federal tax evasion, even accusations related to misappropriation of $8.7 million in a CLICO-related matter involving the Bahamas. In fact, it seems this ambassador, who sat in the cabinet office next to our prime minister, who so hates corruption because he talks about it wherever he goes, and who signed the heads of agreement, has been barred by the U.S. Securities Commission from acting as a broker or investment advisor or otherwise associated with firms that sell securities.
What kind of a show are you guys putting on here today? I mean, the only class in this act is sitting next to me, and I'm here to tell you this boy's soul is intact. It's non-negotiable. You know how I know? Someone here, and I'm not going to say who, offered to buy it. Only Charlie here wasn't selling.
Sir, you're out of order.
Out of order? I show you out of order. You don't know what out of order is, Mr. Trask. I'd show you, but I'm too old. I'm too tired. I'm too fucking blind. If I were the man I was 5 years ago, I'd take a flamethrower to this place. Out of order. Who the hell do you think you're talking to? I've been around, you know. There was a time I could see. And I have seen. Boys like these, younger than these, their arms torn out, their legs ripped off. But there is nothing like the sight of an amputated spirit. There is no prosthetic for that. You think you're merely sending this splendid foot soldier back home to Argonne with his tail between his legs, but I say you are executing his soul!